Hello, my name is Nate, and I'm a product specialist here at CollaborateMD. I'm excited to introduce you to our medical billing software. We'll be covering sections at a high level, creating claims, posting payments, and running reports. Please visit our Knowledge Center at any time to view step-by-step instructions and more detailed information. Let's get started. CollaborateMD can be accessed from anywhere, as long as you have a valid internet connection. Simply type app.collaboratemd.com into a supported web browser and then log in with your CMD credentials. We've made navigating CMD straightforward with the left-hand side menu. The search bar at the top helps you find sections quickly and efficiently. Core sections are grouped together to make it easier to find what you're looking for. Let's start by exploring the tools and features in the home section. This is your welcome dashboard. It consists of gadgets that provide you with key performance metrics. Each gadget pulls different information from within each section of your CMD account and includes tips and short descriptions that help you decide which one to use. Dashboards are easily customizable, so you can track the data that is most important to your business. Since we're talking about dashboards, let's hop over to that section. As you can see, this section looks very similar to the welcome dashboard. The difference here is that you can add multiple dashboards and gadgets. You have more information at your fingertips, so you can quickly analyze and identify different trends to keep your business running smoothly. We know another aspect of running a successful business is having effective communication with your staff. So we've added two important tools to help you stay organized and efficient: messages and tasks. Messages and tasks can be found on the top toolbar and can be accessed from any screen in CMD, which takes your multitasking to the next level. Messages allow you to send secure internal CMD correspondence to users linked to your account or to any of our CMD departments. You can quickly view messages, multi-select messages to delete, mark as read, unread, or move to another folder. Tasks give you the ability to create and edit reminders so you and your team can stay on track. Easily assign tasks to yourself or other users. You also have the ability to add due dates, links, descriptions, statuses, and priorities. The next section we're going to review is your account management and administration section. This is an important step to manage your account, customers, and user access. Our first stop is account management, where you'll go to edit any of your main account information. The Payment Profile screen is where you will add your bank or card information to make payments to CMD. We require that you have at least one active payment profile. Our accounting team will reach out to you if your credit card on file is about to expire. The Invoice section is where you can view your CMD invoices and receive an overview of your payments. Your account will be auto-debited on the 5th of every month. You can view your payment history by clicking the Payment History tab. If you want to see a complete breakdown of your invoices, payments, and credits on your account, just click the Print Account Summary button. If you are a billing service or have distinct practice locations, the Customer Management section is where you can create customer accounts or separate databases under your main account. We advise billing services to create a customer account for each of their clients. From this screen, you can add new customers. Use the search bar to easily find and edit existing customers, or manage which users have access to each customer account. Next, your staff is going to need login credentials to access CMD. Within the user management screen, you can add new users, define permissions, roles, and reset passwords. Click the Add User button to create a new user and enter the username and contact info. The permissions side panel is used to define which sections of CMD a user can access. You can set permissions individually or by permission roles. Roles are predefined lists of permissions which can be created for a biller, front desk, or office manager position, for example. The customer access panel lets you pick which customer accounts a user should have access to. Now that you've warmed up to the layout and core functionality of CMD, let's dive into the fun part: completing your account setup so you can start sending out claims and getting paid. The Customer Setup section organizes all of the core components together, so you don't miss a beat. I'm going to start by showing you how to set up your practices, configure providers, facilities, payers, and codes. When you first logged into your account, you were prompted to create your first practice. the practice represents the entity who will be submitting claims to payers. Click the Show All button to find the practice you created in the search box. The practice's information will populate in box 33 of the CMS 1500 professional claim or box 56 of the UB04 institutional claim. Each practice can be configured with specific claim or patient defaults, notes, and other office locations. The provider represents the person that renders services to the patient. You were prompted to create a provider during the account setup process as well. You can find the provider you created using the search bar or by clicking the Show All button. The provider section controls if the provider MPI should populate in box 24J and if the provider is billing as an individual in box 33A on the CMS 1500 professional claim. On the UB04 institutional claim, the provider MPI will populate in box 57. If you open a provider, you can control what provider information will populate on the claim. The bill as determines how the provider bills, either as a group or an individual. Another important piece in the provider section is the Use Which ID Number drop-down menu. This is where you select the provider's tax ID used to bill payers. Facilities are used to represent the place where services are rendered. Since facilities are not always required by payers, you were not prompted to create a facility during the account setup. But if your payer requires a facility, adding a new one is simple. Click the New Facility button to create a facility record and enter the required information. Referring providers are also configured under Customer Setup. Referring providers are doctors that have referred patients to see another specialist. These providers will populate in box 17 on the CMS 1500 professional claim and 78 on the UB04 institutional claim. Just like facilities, referring providers are not always required, and their usage depends on the requirements from your specific payers. To add a referring provider, just click the New Referring button. Since you may not have all the information you need to create a referring provider, you can use the MPI registry to locate the provider and auto-populate their information. It is still best practice to verify you have the correct information before sending the claim to the payer. Your account is starting to come together. We've created the practice, provider, facility, and referring provider records. The next step in setting up your account is adding your payers. Payers are the insurance companies you'll be sending your claims to. CMD has over 2,000 electronic connections with payers. Not all insurance companies have the same requirements, but our CMD application allows you to configure claims differently per payer. To add a new payer, just click the New Payer button. Right off the bat, you'll be asked if you want to configure a clearinghouse connection for this payer. This is really asking if you want to send claims to the payer the fastest way, electronically. If you are planning on printing and mailing the claims yourself, just select No. The Default Charge Status drop-down menu defines the default statuses for any charge that's billed to this payer. The Clearinghouse Processing Mode drop-down menu tells the system how to process the claim. Should the clearinghouse send the claim to this payer electronically? Or should they drop the claim to paper and mail it for you? The Billing Options side panel includes many other options and settings that can be configured per payer. Payer Agreements is the next section we'll visit under Customer Setup. Payer agreements are different than credentialing. Some payers require an additional agreement before you can send claims electronically, check eligibility, or receive ERAs. It is highly recommended you complete payer agreements as soon as possible, as the turnaround time can vary for each payer. Partner with your implementation specialist or visit our Knowledge Center to get more information on completing payer agreements. Codes are one of the last items you need to configure before you're ready to send claims to payers. Codes can range from ICD diagnosis codes to CPT procedure codes. Remittance, revenue, adjustments, and other types of codes are configured under the Code section. Click Show Tips from the Help icon to learn more about adding or creating specific codes. It is also recommended you partner with your payers to identify which codes they may require on your claims. Now that we have gone over the Customer Setup section, you are ready to start adding and managing your patient records. Head over to the Patient section to add and edit your patient demographics, insurance, claim information, and documents. just click the New Patient button and enter all of the required information. You can set up claim defaults for the patient and configure their billing info from here too. One of the most helpful features in CMD is our real-time eligibility checks. If it is included in your plan and your payer supports it, you are able to check your patient's eligibility with the simple click of a button. After configuring eligibility, it can be checked on an individual or on a batch level. For now, we'll walk through on how to check on an individual level. Just open up a patient record and click the eligibility button, then new eligibility check. Select the payer, service type, and date range, then click check eligibility. The results will automatically display if the patient is eligible and will include information about the patient's insurance coverage. Now that your account is set up, patients have been entered and their benefits verified, it's time for the moment we've all been waiting for, creating claims. The claims section is the backbone of CMD. You can create CMS 1500 professional claims, UB04 institutional claims, New York workers' comp, and add claim attachments. Just head over to the claim section and click the add professional or institutional claim button. We've made it as simple as possible for you to select what is added to the claim. Start by adding your patient to the claim by clicking on the magnifying glass next to the patient's field. Depending on your patient's defaults, the provider, practice, facility, referring provider, and insurance information should automatically populate. However, if needed, each record can be changed manually by clicking on the magnifying glass next to each field. Go to the Charges tab to add diagnosis and procedure codes to the claim the same way you added the patient. Just click on the magnifying glass and locate the code. Please partner with your payers to understand all of the requirements they may have and enter additional information into the other tabs. Submitting the claim is effortless. Under the Charges tab, you will find a status column for your procedure codes. This status defines what will be done with the charge. Should it be sent to the payer electronically? Are you going to print and mail the claim to the payer? Or is the balance due to the patient? Once the charges are in the right status, save the claim. Our system will then run the claim through thousands of edits to ensure the claim will be approved by the payer. With our 100% real-time claim submission, if our system detects an error, you'll be notified by a pop-up immediately, so you can go back and resolve the issue. After the claim has been submitted, you'll want to track and follow up with the claim to ensure it was received by the payer. Claim Tracker allows you to monitor and follow up on your claims so you can pursue every dollar. Just enter the criteria for the claim you are searching for. After locating your claim in the list, you'll see any updates we have on the claim, like if the claim made it to the payer, if the clearinghouse found any errors, or if the payer has sent an ERA or EOB back. It's now time for the best part, getting paid. Once you start receiving payments from your patients and payers, it's important to post those payments in CMD to create a record for all the payments received. There are two main types of payments, patient and insurance payments. Posting patient payments is a breeze, especially with our in-app credit card processing. Navigate to the payment section, then select post. Once you are on the screen, just select the patient using the search bar. Enter the payment information and any other required fields. If the patient is paying with a card and you have enabled integrated payment processing, you can process the payment and it will automatically post in CMD. The best part of our in-app payment processing is that it's included in all of our price plans. CMD also gives you the flexibility to automatically or manually define which charge to post the payment towards. CMD is able to post EOB and ERA insurance payments. EOB payments are posted manually via the post screen, while ERAs have their own screen and are posted automatically. Once you are ready to post these types of payments, visit our Knowledge Center or ask your implementation specialist for more information. To wrap this up, we'll touch on our awesome reporting section. Reports in CMD are powerful and easy to use. Reports are important tools for any business to track and measure performance. You can specify the metrics you are tracking and organize data across locations, departments, providers, timeframes, and more. Head over to the report viewer where there are over 125 plus standard reports that you can use to examine your CMD data. All of our standard reports are broken up into 8 folders. Use the search bar to find the report you need. Enter your filters and search criteria, then click Run Report. You can minimize the time your staff has to filter through reports by saving the most used ones to the Favorite Reports pane, and have instant access to commonly used reports with our recently ran reports list. All of our reports run in real time, so you can be confident that you are looking at the most up-to-date information. In the Report Builder section, you have the ability to create and build your own custom reports. You can create them from scratch, or use an existing template as a starting point. You are able to create a report from nearly any data field in the CMD application, so the possibilities are endless. There you have it, an overview of what CMD can do to help you work less and get paid fast. If you're a new account, your implementation specialist will set up a time to begin your training calls. We have created an extensive knowledge center that contains detailed steps and information for each section in CMD. To access our knowledge center, just click on the help icon in the top toolbar, or visit help.collaboratemd.com. Feedback is very important to us. Good or bad, we want to hear from you. Click the submit feedback link found in the top toolbar to let us know how we're doing. Our dedicated group of implementation and support specialists are there to assist you if you need help navigating CMD or have any questions along the way. We are happy to have you on board so you can experience the power of CollaborateMD, work less, paid fast.